What's up guys, it is me Zane, back here with another video. Now today's video is going to be a little bit different from what I normally do. Today's video is going to sort of be like a vlog, but not really. In September of this year, I actually had the privilege of attending the Pharrell X Human Race exhibit that took place at Essence, as well as the Balenciaga event that took place at Essence. Now my main intent wasn't to vlog while I was there, but I did manage to capture some footage on my iPhone, and I thought some of you guys would enjoy it if I turned that into a video. And also for the people out there who did miss out on this opportunity to go, but still wanted to see what the exhibit looked like. All right, hope you guys enjoy. I found this exhibit to be really cool. Of course, I've never really experienced anything like that beforehand. I have been to museums, I have been to a couple exhibits, but this was kind of different. It was also my first time going to Essence, and I heard a lot about it, and it was really cool to be there. So Essence changed the whole exterior of the building to match the human race color, which is green. They put decals on the windows. They had some cool ambient lighting when you walked into Essence. It was completely green, and I really liked that. It kind of immerses you into the actual exhibit. So when I first walked in, I was greeted with a massive screen, and there was a projection of a video of Pharrell speaking. I can't exactly remember what he said, but I do recall him putting up videos of certain people that were a part of the project or that he found to be inspirational, such as Tyler the Creator, SZA, and many, many more. And he said a couple words about them and how they contribute to the world, which followed with a bunch of video clips of them. If you guys don't know, I'm a massive Tyler the Creator fan. I didn't know that he was a part of this project, and he was far more just a part of it. He actually played an important role on one of the sections of the exhibit, which was Pharrell's archive, which was curated by Tyler the Creator. Anyway, surrounding that projection on the walls were massive posters of macro portraits of the celebrities that he was talking about, and I decided to take a picture with Tyler, and there were benches for people to sit and watch. I didn't sit down and watch, but I still watched the video. But on the benches were little pamphlets that you could take, which contained actually a lot of cool things, including a SZA poster and a Tyler the Creator poster, and those were exclusive to that event. You can't find them anywhere else, so I think it's pretty cool that I walked away with a free Tyler the Creator poster, as I'm a massive fan of him. Now, each floor was like a different part of the exhibit. So on that floor, we had that video projection and kind of an introduction to the whole project. And on the second floor, there was this art piece presented that was made by Pharrell. I believe it was made actually in Italy, I could be wrong, but they had this sculpture sent to Essence. Each little cube represents something different about self-care and hygiene. Like for example, you have your little towel mat there. You have, I believe that's a sink. You have a bathtub, pillow, just a bunch of different things. I can't remember exactly everything, but it was just a really, really cool piece to see in person. They also had produced merchandise for this event. I did not buy it, unfortunately. I didn't have any money on me. There were some really nice pieces. There was like this white blank t-shirt with some green embroidery done, and yeah, it was pretty cool. And along the floors, they had these sort of shelves where they had these massive human race boxes. I'm not sure what was in them, but they just had them scattered along the shelves. And on the last floor, we had a bunch more pieces from the human race season. We have some t-shirts over there, we have the skincare products, and some new colorways for the human race NMDs. Personally, I'm not a big fan of the human races. They also had like this coffee bar. I'm not sure why. I think it's always been there, but Pharrell actually took a picture right there a couple hours earlier. Pharrell was actually in the store, and he had been there for like a day, but it was only an exclusive invite only event. He sat down for a Q&A, and he took a picture right there, and I just find that so crazy. And the last part of the exhibit is is an archival collection of pieces of Pharrell's old wardrobe curated by the one and only Tyler, the Creator. I think it's so cool that I was looking at products that were hand selected by Tyler, and I just find that so cool. So Tyler actually picked some pretty cool pieces and some pretty iconic and legendary ones, if I gotta say so myself. First, gotta start off with the one and only Vivienne Westwood Buffalo hat, otherwise known as the Happy Hat, which was worn by Pharrell in his 2014 Coachella performance. I'm still not sure why there are holes in them, but I think it's just such an iconic piece. I feel like Happy was one of the biggest songs in the world, but I don't think it was. But at a certain point, it definitely felt like that. And there was a time that everyone just recognized Pharrell by that hat. And I think it was just really cool to be able to see that in person. And next up, we got the Louis Vuitton x Takashi Murakami luggage. This is just such a crazy piece. I took a picture with it. Pretty insane. I don't know much about it. I just know that Takashi Murakami x Louis Vuitton is very, very rare and very, very expensive. Next up, we got the NERD hat. Now, I'm a massive NERD fan. Love Nerd. Love the Neptunes. There's just so many pictures of him wearing this exact hat, and I just think it was crazy to see it in person. We also got the Billionaire Boys Club jeans, which has been spotted on Pharrell many, many times back in his early Neptunes days. And we also got this tracksuit that I believe was worn by him at the Grammys, if I'm not mistaken. And I actually do remember this piece, him wearing it at the Grammys. So I think it's just crazy to actually visually see it. And that's pretty much it for the whole exhibit. Again, if I probably recorded more, I could probably go into the little nitty-gritty details, but I don't have enough footage to work with, and never mind that. I can't remember everything that happened from 3 months ago. So yeah, that's pretty much it.
Subscribe to Zen Buckle!